Arpita Das Ribeiro.
Yeah.
Back in Goa.
Half of Goa. I know. Gosh.
Tell us about the journey of Yoda Press. We are all proud of its achievement.
That's really a long thing to talk about, and you're giving me like 5 minutes to
five
wrap
minutes
it
5 minutes to
up.
Talk about 15 years. How many years?
It's now 17 years.
17.
Yeah. So basically what I'm going to talk about today is essentially how it began and how it's evolved and how we've stayed afloat against all odds and made a lot of mistakes and learnt a lot along the way, and then forging on and soldiering on, particularly after this absurdly difficult year when we've learned some new tricks, which I want to talk about today as well.
Main challenges now? Top main challenges?
You know, this past year sales have been terrible. I think a lot of independent and small publishers will tell you that. So we've had to sort of reinvent ourselves a little. We've had to understand that because we are so editorial driven, our services are very important in terms of the ecosystem for authors and other organizations. So now we are also offering those. We are sort of, you know, doing manuscript reviews, we are doing developmental editing, author feedback, sort of handholding authors who are not our own, and monetizing that. So that has helped me pay salaries. So I suppose a big challenge right now is to stay afloat, being independent.
The long-term future of Indian publishing looks gloomier or better than what
it is? No, I never think it looks gloomy. I'm not one of those gloom and doom people. I've never been. I think we've got to really work hard and keep reinventing ourselves. And the minute people stop doing that and get stuck in their privileged kind of, you know, wells where they say, oh, it's so bad and what's going to happen now and this new force is coming and that new wave is coming, then it's over for them.
Yeah.
But someone else will take their place.
Who are your inspirations in publishing?
My inspirations in publishing?
From all over the world or wherever.
So I am absolutely a big fan right now of the new and the first president of the International Publishers Association, who's a woman, first woman president in a long time. We've had a woman president, but years ago, after a very long time, and she's the second ever, called Bodur Al-Qasimi. And she is from Sharjah. She also runs this fabulous publishing house there called Kalimat, which does a lot of children's publishing, I believe. But she's an absolute force of nature, very inspirational. And recently, she also started this really wonderful transnational women in publishing platform, and she asked me to also be on the board last year. That's how I got to know her.
Wow.
And then she's recently become the president of the International Publishers Association. I think these are the sort of dialogues, when they are initiated, the people who initiate those sort of dialogues that really excite me. So Bodur I'll mention right away. Editors are many. I mean, so many in our own country. Ravi Dayal, whom I always look upon as my sort of guru. My father, who's now dead and gone, Shukumar Das, for teaching me the marketing end of stuff. And a very, very maverick New York-based publishing person called Richard Nash, who's been a great mentor and advisor to me over the last few years. I think these are the people I'd mention.
Thank you so much. I won't waste your throat because you have a lot of speaking to do, but thanks so much.
Thanks, Frederick. It's a lovely talking to you.
Yeah, lovely place here also. Nice setting in Dean's office.
Lovely place, really. My gosh. You're staying, but no?
Of course. Yeah.